Sometimes Super Bowl halftime shows outshine the actual football game. Here are five performances people are still talking about today. Michael Jackson. Prior to the 1993 show, college marching bands largely dominated the halftime stage. The King of Pop's performance that year was the beginning of the modern-day halftime spectacle it is today. Jackson's show featured moonwalking, feel-good tunes such as We Are the World and a grand finale of Heal the World, sung by Jackson and 3,500 children. Beyoncé. Fast forward 20 years, Beyoncé's 2013 performance dazzled with an all-female band, and there was even a long-awaited Destiny's Child reunion. Bruno Mars. Next up, Bruno Mars's 2014 halftime performance was a huge show production, which featured snazzy gold jackets and as well as a special appearance by the Red Hot Chili Peppers. The show attracted 115.3 million viewers, the most of any halftime show ever, and almost 4 million more than the game itself, according to the Washington Post. U2. Just months after 9/11, while the American people were still reeling from the attacks, U2 performed for the first time at the Super Bowl. The band honored the victims by displaying their names while playing Where the Streets Have No Name. To end the show, Bono opened his jacket to reveal the stars and stripes sewn inside the lining. The most infamous halftime show was definitely 2004's Janet Jackson and Justin Timberlake performance. The former NSYNC member tried to tear off a piece of Jackson's shirt, but instead exposed her right nipple to millions of shocked fans. With such a rich legacy, we can't wait to see what happens this year.